नियतिकृतनियमरहितां ह्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारतीकवेर्जयति. वेर् स्टिल् इन् अविमृष्टविधेयांशदोष. होप्फुलि वी केन् मूव् आन् टु द लास्ट् वन्. लेट् सी, थिङ्क् वी वर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् वि फिनिश् दिस्. We have to start with this. One minute, let me look at the text. Oh, no, 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 no. Here. Pratitau va karavala karala dosahayo yudhi yo aso vijayarjunam ekamallaha yadi bhupatinasa tatra karye viniyujyeta ततः कृतं कृतं स्यात् अत्र स इत्यस्य अनर्थक्यं स्यात्. सो वी सॉ टिल दिस. सो द कॉन्टेक्स्ट हियर इज यत् शब्द एक्सपेक्ट्स तत् शब्द एंड इफ दैट इज एब्सेंट देन इट इज अ दोष. सो इट इज स्टिल वी आर ओनली लुकिंग एट सेपरेट वर्ड्स. वी हैव स्टिल नॉट गॉन टू वेयर इट इज अ विद इन अ समास और समथिंग लाइक दैट. नाउ in this the context in the present shloka karavala karala dosahayaha, here yaha talks of the first half and asau talks of the second half, where asau vijayarjuna ekamallaha, where karna, this is a shloka talking about karna, and he is very capable of competing with arjuna. That is the idea that is being given here in the shloka, where the yat shabda asau adashabda acts as a tat shabda. Hence the tat shabda saha tatra karye viniyujyeta, and the tat shabda in the second line is actually redundant and it is unnecessary. Now there are other words also that can act as a tat shabda, which is idam. We don't need to have yaha saha yat tat. It is not necessary that only the tat shabda should be in the vidheyamsha. We can even have idam shabda, idam as part of the tat shabda, as giving us the idea of a tat shabda. Such an example is given in the next shloka. If you lose thread of what discussion is going on, it will become apparent when I give a summary of the entire dosha at the end. Then you will understand where each and everything falls. So here the where idam shabda also gives an idea of tat shabda. Yes, there is a doubt. Someone has raised hand. I am not able to unmute you. It says you're not connected to audio.
Okay, so in the karavala karala dosahayo shlokala, sorry, one minute.
Yes,
asau shabda asau nradhukku vandu tat shabda artham illa illaya,
it is there. That is why pratitova, that is why he starts off with that.
अत्र असौ इत्युक्त्वा पुनः सः इति तच्छब्दनिर्देशात् अधशब्दस्य तच्छब्द अर्थकत्वं नास्ति इति गम्यते, अन्यथा सः इति व्यर्थं स्यात्.
वेर् इस् दट् इन् द व्याख्यानं द टैम्
सेकेण्ड् रेण्डादु पाराग्राफ्
रेण्डादु पाराग्राफ् ओके. अत्र असौ इत्युक्त्वा पुनः सः इति तच्छब्दनिर्देशात् अधशब्दस्य तच्छब्दार्थकत्वं नास्ति इति गम्यते, अन्यथा सः इति व्यर्थं स्यात् इत्यतः सः इत्यस्य अनर्थक्यं स्यात्. ओके, आम, यु आर् रैट्. सो हियर् करेक्ट् தான். சோ அதனால என்ன சொல்ல வராருன்னா, யோ அசௌ ஆல்வேஸ் மீன்ஸ் ஒன்லி pratyaksham, so it can never give you the meaning of a paroksha tachabdartha. Yeah, okay, so if asau was used as instead of a tachabda apo inge vandu, then the problem would be that saha which is there in the second line would have become anartham. Oh, okay, nan the syatangardiyum na paakavilla. Correct. So pratito vangarche, okay, here asau iti na tachabdartha pratiti. If you look at the first shlokam, asau marut chumbita charuch kesarahang radhla, asau does not mean tat, whereas here it could have meant. So because in the earlier shloka there is no tachabda. That is why he says tachabdartha pratitihi na bhavet. Asau cannot indicate, cannot mean that it is tachabda. Whereas even if, because there in the following shlokam there is a tachabda, adu irundadana illa na adu vandu vyarthama poidungra illa. Okay.
அவர் சொல்ல வருது அசௌ என்னைக்குமே தச்சப்த அர்த்தம் கொடுக்க முடியாதுங்கிறது.
இட்ஸ் வாட் இஸ் ட்ரைங் டு சே. ஏன்னா அடுத்தது வந்து இதம்ங்கிறது வந்து கிவ்ஸ் யூ த தச்சப்த அர்த்தங்கிறார். அசௌ கேன் நெவர் பி எ தச்சப்த அர்த்த. அதஸ்ய தச்சப்தார்த்த தச்சப்த பர்யாயத்வே பாதகமாக இட் கெனாட் பி யூஸ்ட். கரவால கரால தோசஹாயஹ யுதி யோ அசௌ விஜயார்ஜுனைகமல்லஹ யதி பூபதினா சஹ தத்ர கார்யே விநியோஜ்யேத ததஹ க்ருதம் க்ருதம் ஸ்யாத். சோ இங்க வந்து அன்வயம் இப்படி பண்ணிக்கணும். வி ஹாவ் டு லுக் அட் தி அன்வய ஆஸ் யஹ அசௌ கர்ணஹ விஜயார்ஜுனைகமல்லஹ யுதி கரவால கரால தோசஹாயஹ அஸ்தி யதி ச கர்ணஹ பூபதினா தத்ர கார்யே விநிஜ்யேத ததஹ க்ருதம் க்ருதம் ஸ்யாத். சோ யோ அசௌங்கிறது, சோ வாட் ஆக்சுவலி பின்னாடி இன்னும் ஒரு ரெண்டு மூணு ஸ்லோகத்துல பார்த்தேன்னா ஹி ஆக்சுவலி சேஸ் எனி வேர்ட் ஈவன் இட் இஃப் இட் இஸ் தத் சப்த இதம் சப்த அத சப்த எனி திங் இஃப் இட் இஸ் இன் காம்பினேஷன் வித் யஹ யத் சப்தஸ்ய சமீபே யதி அத சப்தாதீனாம் உபஸ்திதிஹி தர்ஹி இட் கேன் நெவர் பி ஈக்குவல் டு தத் சப்த. சோ த ஃபேக்ட் தட் இட் இஸ் near yat shabda it cannot be tat shabda. Whether adu vandu yaha vijayarjunaikam allaha yadi bhupatina asau tatra karyeni yujyeta then asau can be a tat shabda pratiti. It you cannot say that in all places asau cannot be a paryayavachi for tat shabda. Sariya yat shabda samipastha அசௌ சப்தா இல்ல தனியா நம்ம இப்போ வந்து முந்தின ஸ்லோகத்துல பார்த்தோமே இஃப் இன் த கேஸ் ஆஃப் அசௌ மறு சும்பித சாரு கேசரஹா வேர் அசௌ இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் மென்ஷன்ட் செப்பரேட்லி தென் தெர் இஸ் நோ இஷ்யூ. ஓகே ஓகே கிளியர் ஃபைன். நவ் லெட்ஸ் மூவ் ஆன் டு இதம் சப்த வேர் இட்ஸ் இஸ் யஹ அவிகல்பம் இதம் அர்த்தமண்டலம் பஷ்யதி ஈஷ நிகிலம் பவத் வபுஹு ஆத்மபக்ஷ பூரி பரிபூரிதே ஜகதி அஸ்ய நித்யசுகினஹ குதோ பயம். திஸ் இஸ் இன் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்லோகா வேர் ஹி சேஸ் இதம் சப்தஸ்ய லெட் மீ டேக் அப் த இது திஸ் இஸ் ஈஸியர். சோ இதம் சப்தஸ்ய தத் சப்தார்த்தே பிரயோகஹ. நவ யோ அவிகல்பம் இதம் அர்த்தமண்டலம் ஹே ஈஷ ஓ லார்ட். சோ திஸ் the one who sees this entire artha mandalam, artham does not mean just meaning, here he says artha jatam, which is the objects that are there in the world. So the entire gamut of the objects that are present in this world, the one who sees these objects or one who sees the universe as your shariram yatu akhilam bhavad vapuhu akhilam artha mandalam nikhilam bhavad vapuhu iti yaha pashyati tasya. Instead of tasya he uses asya here. Nitya sukhinah asya, he is always in the that bliss mode. he is always clear for such a person in this world. And this world is Atma Paksha Paripurite. Atma Paksham is Atma Swarupa. This entire world is filled with that Brahma Swarupa. And he looks at every, say, Sakalam Arthajatam Yadi Bhagavataha Vapuhu Iti Pashyati. Tarahi Jagat Atma Paksha Paripurite Jagati Kutaha Bhayam Syat. How can there be a fear for that person? Fear is Bhayam. Is equal to samsara bhayam, which is this punarjanma. The fear of janma and punarjanma is the problem. Okay. Here, yaha pashyati asya kutaha bhayam. That is your uddeshyamsha and videyamsha. So, uddeshyamsha is yaha pashyati asya kutaha bhayam. That is your videyamsha. So, yachabda expects a tachabda. Instead of a tachabda, here you have asya, which is the shashti vibhakti for idam shabda. So, idam shabda is used for tachabda. And that also, it is in a vakyantaram. Whereas in yo asau, it is not in a different vakya. Yo asau tava is still part of that yachabda amsha. And that agataha is the only word that indicates the tachabdamsha. And that asau has not come here. Yaha tava asau agataha. If it had been in a different sentence, then there is no issue. So for that, he is taking up this example. The next example he says is iti idam shabdavat adas shabdaha tachabdartham abhidatte ityuchyate iti. So this part is your purvapaksha. Idam iti idam shabdavat, just like how in this shloka yo avikalpam, idam shabda has been used as a tachabda. In the same way, can we have tava asau or yo asau tava agataha in that shloka apanga samsargi? In that shloka also, adas shabda can indicate tachabda. So that is the Purvapakshi's question here. Iti idam shabdavat, just like idam shabda, adas shabda can also indicate abhidatte. What can it indicate? Tachabdartham. Iti chet uchyate. I'm giving the answer here. Tarhi atra iva, just like here, atra iva yo avikalpam iti shloke, atra iva vakyantare upadanam arhati. Vakyantare adas shabdasya upadanam arhati. So adas should have been used in a separate sentence and not as combined with yo asau. Na tatraiva, not tatraiva ityukte yachabda samipe eva. Upayogaha na arhati. Either adashabda or tachabda or idam shabda, anything which indicates the pronoun, what will happen to that when it is said near to the yachabda? So yachabdasya hi nikate sthitaha prasiddhim paramrishati. It only indicates something which is already known or which is very famous, which is known very well to the, either the context or people of the world. We don't need to mention it in that manner. For that, he gives an example where even the tachabda, if it is indicated along with the yachabda, if it is present with the yachabda, it is only a prasiddhamatra paramarshaha and paramarshaha. There is, it expects another tachabda there. So the, for that, he gives an example. Yattad urjitam atyugram kshatram tejo asya bhupatehe divyata akshaihi tada anena noonam tadapi haritam. So here, yate tate, the context of the shloka is Veni Samharam. In the first act, Yudhishthira is being censured by Bhima. So Bhima scolds Yudhishthira by saying that, you know, I think he has lost in that prasiddha tejas that he has. He has lost even that during the dice play. When he was playing, he probably lost his prakasham or his parakramam also along with the in the dice game along with all his wealth. So it is in the form of a ninda that Bhima talks to Sahadeva in this manner about Yudhishthira. So yat tat urjitam atyugram kshatram tejaha asya bhupatehe, this king had a great very strong atyugram urjitam, very strong atyugram, very fearsome kshatram tejaha, the kshatriya parakrama that he had. Asya bhupatehe yat tat, tat prasiddham yat urjitam ugram tejaha asya bhupatehe asit, tat tadapi haritam. So you have that tat again mentioned in the second line. Divyata akshaihi tada divyata anena noonam tadapi haritam. So akshaihi divyata anena, anena ragnya, akshaihi divyata, aksha is the dice, divyati means it plays the dice in the game. So akshaihi divyata, as he played during the dice play, he probably lost his valor. Tadapi haritam noonam. I think definitely he has lost his valor also there. And he, that is why he is not showing any sort of parakrama at this point. Now, context, what are we looking at here? Yat tat prasiddham tejaha tadapi haritam. So, yat tad urjitam tejaha bhupatehe urjitam tejaha tadapi haritam. Now, the first tat shabda that is there, which is present near yat shabda, is actually prasiddhimeva bodhayati natu tachabda, it is natu vidheyamsham bodhayati. So the dvitiya tachabda alone gives you the vidheyamsha. Okay, so the first tachabda is actually part of the uddeshyamsha. If the second one was absent, if we did not have tadapi haritam, and if we did not have that dvitiya tachabda, then it would be a dosha. Okay. So ityatra tachabdaha. So I think that ityatra tachabdaha means that first tachabda also indicates that it is a prasiddhartha and it is not that vidheyamsha. Nanu katham. Now the next section is how many yakshabda have to be used. For how many tachabda? Does it have to match? Not necessary. If you remember the Yoya Shastram Vibharti, Swabhuja Guru Madaha, if you count the number of yachabda and the number of tachabda, it will never match. It is not necessary. So he's asking a question here, Nanu, katham, how is it that in this portion, yatu and tatu are not going to match. The number of yat shabda and the number of tat shabda are not going to match here. So kalyananam tvamasi mahasam bhajanam vishwamurte dhuryam lakshmim athamayi brisham dehi deva prasida yadyat papam pratijahi jagannatha namrasya tanme bhadram bhadram vitara bhagavan bhuyase mangalaya. This is a shloka from Malati Madhavam. In the first act, the Sutradhara says this in the form of a Surya Prarthana. And he says, Kalyananam Tvamasi Mahasahe Vishwamurte, you are the Lord of the entire universe, Vishwamurte, Tvam Kalyananam Mahasam Kalyananam Bhajanam Asi. You are the Bhajanam, you are the Adharam for Mahasam Kalyananam, Kalyananam Mahasam. So the auspicious Prakasha that comes for anybody in this entire universe, you are the Adhara for that Prakasha. So Mahasam Bhajanam, Mahasam Tejasam Bhajanam, Asi Adharaha Asi Tvam. Dhuryam Lakshmim Atha Mayi Bhrisham Dehi. So Atha, hence, because you possess the quality of auspicious prakasham. So kalyana prakasha is there for you. And that prakasha gives life to everybody in this world. I want you to give me dhuryam lakshmim. The dhuryam is actually bhara vahana kshamam lakshmim sampattim dehi. Give me or brisham dehi. Atishayena mayi madvishaye dehi. So here the saptami is vishaya saptami. So mayi, for me, give me that Lakshmi or that prosperity with which I can be the first and foremost in the Natya or the Natakam. so that I can perform this nataka in a very proper manner. So he says, Duryam Lakshmim, the first and foremost of prosperity that any actor would want, give me that. Dehi Deva Prasida Prasannaha Bhava Prasida. Yadyat Papam, hey Jagannatha, you are the world's lord of the whole world. Yadyat Papam Prati Jahi, Yadyat Papam Asti, Tat Sarvam Prati Jahi. So Tat Me Bhadram Bhadram Vitara Bhagavan Mangale Mangalaya Bhuyase Mangalaya Namrasya Mama Dehi. So here I am bowing to you. Namraha means Vinaya, Vinaya Yuktaha Aham. So I'm bowing to you with so much of humility. So for my bhuyase mangalaya, in order to provide mangalam for me, you remove, destroy each and every papam that I have done, and may bhadram bhadram vitara, give me a mangala for each of the papam that you destroy. Here he uses yadyat iti uktva tan me iti uktam. How will that fit? So yatyat, just like in the earlier shloka, you have yat tat urjitam, and there you said yat tat is prasiddhartam, so another tat is expected, hence yat tat is a combination there, and that tat is your vidheyamsha. Now here, how will you explain? There are two uddeshyamsha, yat yat papam. Whereas in the Vidheyamsha, you have only one tat me vitara. Yatyat papam pratijahi. Whatever is the papa that I have made, pratijahi, you remove that, nashaya. Tat mangalam dehi, tat bhadram dehi, and give me that bhadram that is associated with that, or give me the opposite of that papam that I have performed. Okay? Now, how would it fit? Yatyat iti uktva, tat me iti uktam, tat dehi. Now here, yatyat iti, yena kena chit rupena sthitam, sarvatmakam vastu akshiptam, tata bhutameva tat shabdena paramrishyate. Now the answer here, more than this, it is better to look at Tarkam, where he says, yatra yatra dhumaha, tatra vannihi, he will not say tatra vannihi. Then Ayyayika will always use the word only once in that. So yavatsu sthaleshu dhumaha vartate, tavatsu sthaleshu agnihi vartate, tatra agnihi vartate. So you don't need tatra vannihi vartate. If you say, then it means it exists in some of those places, tatra, if you use the tatra in two places. So whatever papam you have destroyed, I am taking it in entirety and saying it is just one. Yadyat papam tat sarvam ekam. Ityashayena yadyat iti dvivaram uktam. So the Vidheyamsha will only indicate one tat. Now how does he take it? Yena kena chit rupena sthitam yadyat papam. Tukte manasikam, vachasikam, kayikam, iti sarvatra. So whatever forms of papa that you have done, that I have done, so yena kena chit rupena sthitam papam iti yadyat. Sarvatmakam vastu akshiptam. The papam in its entirety is being sent here. Tatha bhutameva tachabdena paramrishyate. So tat vitara, tat badram vitara. Here that tatpadam is, he uses that tatpadam as indicative of one single entity of that papa. Yadyat papam tat pratijahi bhadram vitara. You just have to take it as two different sentences. I kept thinking that tat bhadram vitara. It's actually tat pratijahi. So yadyat papam asti tat pratijahi. Okay. So yadyat iti uktva tanme iti uktam. Tatra Uchyate. So that is your Purupakshi point. From Uchyate, you have the Siddhanti, where he explains that and says, Yadyate iti, yena kena chid rupena stitam, sarvatmakam, vastu akshiptam, tatabhutameva tachabdena paramrshyate. Now, this next portion is actually samasagata example. This is till now we saw asamasagatam, vakyagatam, kintu vakyagatam, abhimrishtavideyamsham. Now this example is actually samasagatam, vakyagatam, abhimrishtavideyamsham, kintu samase, anekapadagatatvat, samase api. How it affects the entire vakyam, hence it is taken as vakyagatam and not as a padagatam. Okay, kim lobhena vilangitaha sabharataha yena etad evam kritam matra stri laghutam gata matra kama stri laghutam gata kim athava mata eva me madhyama mithya etan mama chintitam dvitayamapi arya anujo asau guruhu mata tata kalatram ityanuchitam manye vidhatra kritam. So the context here, Lakshmana is thinking of why Rama was sent to the forest. Kim lobhena vilangitaha sa bharataha. Is it bharataha? Bharata probably lobhena vilangitaha. He was probably extremely greedy. And yena etat matra evam kritam. That's why I said you have to take that matra to the previous line. So probably Bharata was so greedy to get the Rajyam, and that's why he used his mother to get the Rajyam for himself, get the kingdom. So, kim lobhena, kim Bharataha lobhena vilangitaha. Was he, did he have an excessive greed that yena, because of which, yasmat karanat, etat rajya bhramsha karyam or rama vanavasa adi karyam matra kritam kaikeyi dwara evam karita athava kim athava or madhyama mata eva me madhyama mata eva stri lagutam gata. Was she did she have this small mindedness that women always have? Okay. And that is why she performed this action. Then he says, mithya etat mama chintitam. Mama chintitam, my thoughts such as these, you know, whether Bharata was excessively greedy or whether it was Kaikeyi herself who adopted this kshudrata that is very natural for stri. Okay, mithya etat mama chintitam. This both my thoughts are mithya. It is false. It is not true. Dvitayam api. Kimartham, he explains it. He justifies it by saying, arya anujaha asau mama guruhu. Mama guruhu, jeshta bhrata asau bharataha. Arya anujaha, ramasya anujaha eshaha. He is in fact Rama's brother. How can he behave in such a manner? I cannot expect him to behave like this. Matatu tata kalatram. See, Dasharatha is such a truthful person. And I cannot expect Dasharatha's wife to behave in such a manner. Ataha etat mama chintitam mithya. Iti anuchitam. So, anuchitam goes there. So, mata tatakalatram ityataha, hence I feel manye vidhatra idam anuchitam kritam. I think it is the fault of vidhata, fate, that this anuchitam karyam kritam. Rame rajyam pitur abhimatam sammatam cha prajanam. In Paduka Sastram, he says, it's actually very beautiful text that you have to read. Rame Rajyam Pitur Abhimatam Sammatam Cha Prajanam. People also accepted that the kingdom has to be given to Rama. Pitur Abhimatam. Dasharatha wanted it, but at the same time he had to ask the praja for that. So prajanam sammatam cha mata vavre. At that point of time, mata vavre, Kaikeyi wanted that rajyam for herself. And so she asked in the form of a vara. So mata vavre tadapi bharate satyavadi dadau cha. So she wanted to give it to Bharata, and Rama gave it to Bharata also. Satyavadi dadau cha chintatita samajanitada paduke padukagrya abhishekaha durvijnana swa hridayam aho daivamatra pramanam. The words are very So daivamatra pramanam, he says the only person who got the rajyabhisheka done, the one who got the rajyam, was the paduka, nobody else. People wanted it for Rama, Dasharatha wanted it for Rama, Kaikeyi wanted it for Bharata, Bharata gave it back to Rama, Rama also gave it back, but he sent his paduka instead. Hence the abhishekam happened for the paduka. So ultimately daivamatra pramana, very similar to that he says here. Anuchitam manye vidhatra kritam, but he scolds the vidhi and says, you know, vidhi is the one who has to be blamed for Rama Vanavasa. Anuchitam kritam vidhina. Okay, the point here is atra aryasya iti tatasya iti cha vachyam natu anayoho samase guni bhavaha karya evam samasantare api udaharyam. And the here Aryanujaha is the problem word, and Tata Kalatram is also the problem word. See, Aryanujaha asau guruhu mataja tata paradhanyam, and so the pradhanam will go to the Kalatram and the pradhanyam will go to Anujaha instead of Aryasya and Tatasya. Why we need the pradhanyam there? It is because Aryasya Anuja, given the qualities of Rama, what are all the qualities that we know about Rama? And Bharata, being the younger brother of Rama, he will naturally have those qualities, and he will not behave in such a manner that shows his excessive greed. Hence, the importance here should be where Aryasya Anujaha. Aryasya Anujaha asau mama guruhu, that is the Uddeshyamsha. Videyamsha is your Aryasya Anujaha, and the Arya should get Pradhanyam there. Since it is gone into the Samasa, the Pradhanyam goes for the Anujaha and not for Aryaha, who is Rama and his qualities. So that does not gain, it is such a Guni Bhavaha, it becomes a Guni Bhutatva. Next is the same manner. Tata Kalatrasya, Dasharatha being of such a high quality, being his wife, Kaikeyi will not have such a greed for that Rajyam. She will not behave in such a manner, or she will not have that Stri Laghutvam being Dasharatha's wife. So here the Pradhanyam should be for Tatasya and not as in the Shashti Tatpurusha, it goes to the Kalatra. The Pradhanyam goes to the Kalatra. So Tata Sammandaha Arya Sammandaha cha Atra Pradhanyena Vaktavye. Yeah. Evam Samasantare Api Udaharyam. Now you can look at other Samasas also, where the, you know, with the Bahuvrihi Samasam also, it becomes in, we saw in that Vrithochunaihi Yakkaro Hyamevame Yadarayaha. In that we saw that Kim Evihi Bujaihi. In that also we saw Vritho Uchunaihi, but that became the Padakatattvam because the entire sentence itself was formed as one Pada in the Samasam. Whereas here, Tata Kalatram Mata, you have two separate words. Hence, it is a Vakya Gatam, and at the same way, Arya Anujaha Asau Guruhu, it is a Vakyam, and in that Vakyam, the Pradhanam should be for Aryasya, and it is gone inside the Samasa, hence there is no Pradhanyam for it. That is why we have the Avimrishta Videyamsha. Now, let me just do one small recap of this Avimrishta Videyamsha, otherwise we are not going to understand this, how he has gone through the entire section. So, let me just go through this once. In the beginning, we saw that, so Abhimrishta Videyamsha Dosha is of two types. You have the Vakya Gatam, and of course you have the Padagatam, then Vakya Gatam, Padamsha Gatam and all that. But here in the Vakya Gata Abhimrishta Videyamsha, you have two types. One is Asamasa Gatam and Samasa Gatam. First, he starts with the Asamasa Gatam, where the Pada, the words are not in a compound word. So first he said about Pourvaparya Viparyayaha, where the Yat Shabda or the Tat Shabda, the Ayameva Nyakaraha, it should have been, Ayameva should have been first, Nyakaraha should have been behind, where the Uddeshyamsha should have been mentioned before and the Videyamsha should have been mentioned later. Hence, Nyakaro Hyayameva is a Dosha Yuktam. That is your first type of Asamasa Gatam Vakya Gatam, which is the Pourvaparya Viparyayaha. The second one is your Videya Anupastitihi. This is where the discussion of Yattat combinations started. The example he gave for this in this Asamasa Gatam is Apanga Samsargi, where we saw Yo Asau Tava Agataha was the Dosha Yuktam Shloka. From there, he moved on to the Yat and Tat combinations, where if you say Yo Asau, Yaha can be taken as the Uddeshyamsha and the Asau can be a part of the Videyamsha, where Asau Agataha could have been taken. Whereas here, he says it cannot happen like that. And then he starts the discussion of how Yat Shabda expects a Tat Shabda, Yattadoho Nitya Sambandha. In that Nitya Sambandha, you find Yat Shabda need not be mentioned also. Tat Shabda need not be mentioned, or both need not be mentioned, or both can be present. So he gives, takes up various situations where it is not a dosha. So the next few shlokas are actually adosha sthala, whereas the only dosha sthala is apanga samsargi until now. In that we saw yaha asau. Now what is the examples here? Yat shabda anapekshatvam is his first discussion, where he says yat shabda is not necessary in places where the tat shabda can be a prakrantartha or the prasiddhartha or anubhavartha, anubhutartha. Prakrantartham, he gave the example of katarjam kevala anitihi, which is the raghuvamsha shloka, where he says saha siddhim anviyesha yaha kevala anitihi katarjam. So he does not give any of the yachabda amsha at all, because that saha is gives us the meaning of the contextual. It is in the context and it is in the kavya. Hence, we don't need a yachabda, because we know what yaha atitihi raja, that we know because of the context. The next is Prasiddharthakam, where he says Dvayam Gatam Samprati Shochaniyatam, where he uses the word Sa Kantimati Kala, Kalavataha, Kalavataha Sa Kantimati Kala. And here that Sa is actually a Prasiddhartha, where it is popularly known that Chandrakala is very beautiful. You don't need to say Ya Chandrasya Kala, Sa Kalavataha Kantimati. We don't need that Sa, we don't need the Yat Shabda there. The same way, Anubhutarthaka Tachabda, Utkampini was the shlokam that we saw, where the Te Lochane is the Anubhutartham, where Udayana is suffering because he hears the news that Vasavadatta is dead. That is actually not Ratnavali, but in another text I came across that it is... Tapasa, I was looking at the work that it was. It is written by Matra Raja and the work is called Tapasa Vasavadatta. No, Tapasa. Oh, I had mentioned it somewhere. I don't know where I had kept that, where I had noted down the text name. So it is neither Ratnavali nor Swapna Vasavadattam or anything, any popular work. This is Tapasa Vatsaraja. Yes, Tapasa Vatsaraja, written by Matra Raja. That is the work from which it has been taken, Utkampini. where Udena is experienced the lochana, the eyes that he had experienced, he had seen before. He is talking of those, so he need not say ye maya anubhute te lochane. That ye maya anubhute section is not there, and it is not expected also, because it is a personal experience that the Nayaka has experienced. And so he says te lochane is an anubhutarthaka tachabda. The next he says, where the tachabda is not necessary, and for that example he takes sadhu chandramasi, and in that sadhu chandramasi, that's a Tat sadhu kritam is the portion needed, and that tachabda is absent. Whereas yat pushkaraihi militam is present. Where both yat and tat are mentioned, he takes the example of yenama kechidihanav prathayantyavagnyam tan pratinaisha yatnaha. In the same example, if you look at utpatsite asti mamakopi samana dharma, in the second, third line and the fourth line, if you find that, there is no yat shabda, nor is there a tat shabda. Both are absent, yet that idea is being conveyed to us. So that yenama kechi dihanaha is an example for both yat tat upadanam, yat tat shabdasya anupadanam, also shabda yoho anupadanam. Next he goes to how asau iti, sorry. I think I made a mistake here, because then she pointed out 1 minute. So adashabdasya. So here adashabdasya, next he goes to karavala, where as we mentioned, it is actually yachabda samipavarti adashabdaha, then it still does not indicate tachabda. Next he goes to idam shabda, where the tachabda prayoga idam can be used instead of tachabda. And then he says yat shabda samipasthaha tat shabdaha, where yat tad urjitam. We saw all these today, so I'm not going into detail. Next is how many ever yat shabda is present. You don't have to have, it is not an is equal to in relationship to 1, 2, 3. You can't count the yat shabdas and you can't count the tat shabdas and say. You will have to go into the meaning of what it indicates. Just as in yat yat papam tat pratijahi. That is enough. Whatever yavanti papani santi, tat sarvam is enough. Tat one tat is enough in that shloka. The last one was the samasakatam. The best example for that last yavantaha tat shabda yachabdaha, if you look at yoyash shastram vibharti, it is the best example for that instead of this kalyanana, where he has some 8 or 9 yachabda. Yoyash shastram vibharti swabhujaguru madaha. Whereas there is only tasya tasya antakaha, where he has only 2 tat shabda there, whereas there will be 8 or 9 yat shabda there. You can look at that shloka, which is a better example. So it does not expect. Now the entire discussion of yat tat combination is over. He goes back to the original thread of avimrishta videyamsha, which is vakyagatam, and in that he takes up the example of only shashti tatpurusham, which is in this Arya Anujaha and Tata Kalatra. Okay. The last dosham is Viruddha Matikrita. Let's look at this later. During the next class, I will look at this and then go on to Padamsha Dosham. Hmm?